not here. Could I have gotten some bad information?
Detective Chase.
Yeah? How did you know that?
My name is Marianne Smith. You were making inquiries about Jonathan Graham Jr.
You know the guy?
We used to be friends. Once he found himself in need of money. Lots of money.
You gave it to him?
I gave him my mother's locket. Graham pawned it to a moneylender. Someone named Frankie the Fatso.
I see. Thanks for the tip. I'll keep an eye out for your locket as well. Since Joe hit the pavement, I'll have to turn to my only other source, my old boss. A gun? How could I have missed it? Well, if the Scribbler decided to get a gun, he must be running scared. Major McKenzie.
Detective Chase. Well, now that the formalities are over, you can tell me why the hell you've shown your mug here again. You got another arrest you want to screw up for me?
Those schlubs were small time! We couldn't get our hands on the real culprit, the brains of the operation.
Maybe. But you had your own score to settle, and you turned your back on us for the sake of some vendetta.
Major McKenzie!
I'll be back to deal with you, Detective. Don't go anywhere.
That was a lucky break, but McKenzie will be back soon. I only have a couple of minutes to rummage through his stuff. The access code is changed every week. McKenzie usually keeps it in a safe. Locked. The Major must have left some kind of reminder in here. A few books are missing from the shelf. Thank you. Hopefully, the Major won't be too angry. I wish I didn't have to enter through the front door. It's too crowded outside. There must be another way. Too high. I can't quite reach it. The window's too high. I can't quite reach it. Here. I need to turn it on. Thank you. Something is seriously wrong with this painting.
I don't even know what to say. How did you manage? Have you found Graham?
Not yet, but I've got a hunch.
Thank you, Detective. I won't disturb you further. I've already wasted enough of your time.
Yeah, I should prepare myself for a visit to the cactus. Look.